the boys of Makati FC earned the respect of football teams around the world after showing their talents in the recent Paris World Games and Gothia Cup in Sweden. The young Filipino booters finished second in the Paris World Games and they also reached the quarterfinals of the Gothia Cup. And here with us to talk about their experience are the captains of the under-13 and under-14 teams, Jared Peña and Alfonso Gonzalez. And we also have local football icon, Coach Tomas Dozano, the founder of Makati FC. Coach Tomas, Alfonso, Jared, thank you so much and congratulations for gaining medals in the Paris World Games and the Gothia Cup. Welcome back, gentlemen, to Game Time. All right, Coach Tomas, so how was the whole experience, of course, in Paris and in Gothia Cup? Were you satisfied with the results?
Well, we're very satisfied with the result in the football because we play in Paris, a new tournament, who had only about 30 countries, but the standard of game being mostly French teams and Europeans, very good. France is the world champion. And we were fortunate out of five teams to reach the 13 and the 14 in the final. We lost only to Paris Saint-Germain, which is one of the biggest clubs in the world. And they have a special, they call in France, a center of excellence. So the big cities of France have each one a big center where all the best players, 12 to 16, play and will become professional. So just to challenge them, and 2-1, we were very close. We are very happy. In Sweden, so many teams, there are 1,700 teams, and so hard to reach. But again, we won 7 games out of 9 possible with the final. They reached the last 8 quarterfinals, and it's wonderful. Yeah. We only lost against Brazil in the big boys, 14, and against the future champion, the Sweden from Stockholm, the 13 years old. So.
Of course, it is a tough competition. As you mentioned, it increased in the number of teams. But what were the biggest learnings for all of the divisions?
Well, learning for them is to be involved with the best kids in the world and to play every day 1 or 2 games, to see other countries, other cultures, other way of playing, and to realize, I think by now they know, that we are also growing up and we are also becoming better and better. As a matter of fact, in Sweden, it's like Wimbledon in the tennis. They have a center with the best teams play, and they were given the privilege and opportunity to be in the center, like you are in Wimbledon. Center court.
Yes, all right.
That already was something special because every game there are 5,000-10,000 people watching. It's live on TV in the whole Europe, even the Philippines they can watch, and that was a big thing. Another experience that they. Okay. They only them know what they like.
All right. So, Alfonso, it is your fourth time, and welcome back to the program. You guys here before you left. How different is it this time around? Considering that it's your fourth time, but how was it? How was your performance, and at the same time, how was the overall experience this year?
This year was much harder because our opponents this year they're much bigger than how they were before. Now they're probably like all much bigger than me, and like now this is like the time where kids nowadays, they try to focus a lot now, like they train as hard as they can just to be the best they can in football.
All right, so Jared naman, it's your second time. You're the captain for the under 13. So how was your experience? I know you guys also played under the Eiffel Tower. There's a field near there. So can you tell us more about it?
Actually, the experience there on playing like close to the Eiffel Tower is really a moment to remember always, because getting to play under or close to a really big place in Paris, which is like an Eiffel Tower.
How was the competition in your age group?
Oh, the competition there is like way different than the Philippines, because in the Philippines it's not that big of a competition like in other countries, especially in Europe.
For your division, naman, Alfonso, how is it? Can you expand it further? You said the kids are a lot bigger, they're going more specialized, but you know, how challenged were you from an individual and team perspective?
We were challenged in many different ways, but. In the team way, there were some teams that had the entire team was all, they all played very well. They knew exactly how each other played, so which was harder to play against just like individual playing styles, you know. So it was much harder, yeah.
Coach Thomas, you want to add to that?
No, it was harder, and then we challenged England, we challenged America, we challenged, unfortunately, in the groupings, you know, like tennis, you don't know, they had to challenge Brazil, which was a wonderful team, and they challenged the champion of Sweden, 11-time champion in the last 11 years, Bromma Poiken. 2 years in a row, they eliminate us. But a lot of learning to do. Alfonso said he's the goalkeeper of the team and he's our tallest players. But all the average of the other teams were like him. It looks like in Europe, in America, in Africa, young kids are growing. Maybe we'll ask them what food they eat or what drink.
Maybe we can copy the scene so we can be like that.
Technically, we're okay, but there is a time. The physical, it's important also. We need two or three more years for them to grow.
Yes, all right. So I noticed, Fonso and Jared, you're wearing a piece of hardware. Of course, the under 13 and the under 14 teams placed second place in the Paris World Games. And at the same time, for the under 13, you guys made a quarters.
Yes.
And
yep.
you get a participation medal. But how special was it for you, Jared? Do you realize now the feeling that...
We came in and, of course, we make
that your team placed eighth. And how was that like?
Actually, it's a really good feeling, and being like eighth in like
the world.
Yeah, in the world, there's like what Coach Ma said. There's like about 154 teams in our age group, and making the top eight, it's a really good thing for the club.
Now you're going to be coming back to your clubs and your teams. So what is it? That you're gonna take. What is it that you took back, and that you're gonna apply, or maybe share with your teammates, Fonso? Other teammates that are here in the Philippines that.
One thing that we have to take back is to always train harder, just so we know now how high the level of competition it is internationally. So we know how much harder we have to train, so we can probably be better than them, and we took back different types of values like sportsmanship and respect.
For you, Jared.
For me,
you're the captain of the under 13 team.
Yeah.
All right.
So for me, to bring back here is like new team plays, techniques, and how we should play like the other teams so that we can compete internationally better.
Lastly, Coach Tomas, go ahead.
I just wanted to add that in my experience, so many years I do this. There's always a special game that year, and that special game was in Gothia. We play about 5,000 to 6,000 people in a special field, and we play against Ukraine, which one of the best teams in Europe, and we were losing until the last 2 minutes, 1-0. Then we score a goal, and then penalties, and we won penalty. That they are games that will be for them special or their life, and for us also.
And of course, the heart of the Filipino is always there wherever you go.
And we had many. We had close to 300 Filipino community who support us all the time.
All right. So there you have it. Coach Tomas Lozano, Jared Peña, and Alfonso Gonzalez, thank you so much for representing, of course, the Philippines, and more power to Philippine football.
Thank you
so much.